Hey, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Tuesday Night Showcase with myself, Stephen Jones, here rocking the valley. And we thank you very much for joining us tonight. We've got ourselves a special rock youth type guest tonight, Will McKnight. Hi, Will.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, we've got some housekeeping to take care of. Then we're going to plunge into it with Will here. He seems like a really nice guy, unless he like puts on fangs or something and just fools me. yeah, we've been getting a lot of rock, youth on. I owe a Paolo a call today. Paolo was on last week, and unbeknownst to myself, something updated and it changed my settings, so we could only hear me or him. So we opted to hear him. We're going to reshoot that show. Paolo also joined our group. He's going to be doing some marketing for us. So you can see Paolo and Vanessa and Liam and a lot of our new rock youth group out at the Kale Hump Farm every Sunday from 3 to 5 with Bill Matei. That's Kale Hump Farm at 1311 Santee Hill Mill Road in Bethlehem. That's off of Route 191. If you're heading off of 22, it's about a mile or so down. Right after the first light there at the Dunkin' Donuts. Stop and get coffee. Bring your own stuff because we're not set up yet to start serving food or anything. And it's all acoustic. Don't come in there looking to start doing any Eddie Van Halen or anything unless you're going to do it on. Yeah, it's all acoustic. It's on the farm. It's really nice. It's outdoors, so it's weather permitting. And we have a good time. Yeah, we have a lot of good old standbys coming in. We've had Tom Walls there. We've had John Coogan, I mean. Bill sits there and he'll play too. And you know, we've got a lot of good stuff that goes on there. And at the end, okay, Pete gets up there and he does a complete round. Everyone gets up and we play some oldies out of there. Sometimes he might end up doing some Roy Orbison. And I know, Will, do you know who Roy Orbison is?
Yes, I do. Is that the Pretty Woman?
Thank you. Oh, my God.
Walking down the street.
I mean,
I know one song.
Well,
one
that's song, good. That's well, you know the important one. So
yeah, the radio one.
Yeah, I mean, earlier we were doing some different songs, and he says, I don't know who that is. Joan Jett. That was on Joan Jett.
I don't know who Joan Jett is.
Oh, my God.
It's too old for me.
Oh, Joan Jett's having heart failure right now. Joan Jett is one of these people that's like, you know, she's 29 forever. Okay. She is.
Yeah.
Her music is to die for. It's great music. Okay. And it is the cornerstone of rock from out of the 80s. I Love Rock and Roll is her song.
Okay? Oh, wait.
I know what she is.
Yeah, yeah. Well, the song you were playing before was like some B-side, so I didn't know that.
Here's a funny antidote. And I got to do my homework here, but do you know what the song Rock Around the Clock?
You'd have to like
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock, 5, 6, 7 o'clock, eight o'clock. Okay, thank you.
I recognize that.
Yeah, I tell you what, half of Milwaukee just left because I started singing. But that song was a B-side song.
Oh, snap.
Yeah, it was a B-side song, and it was played by Bill Haley out of Lancaster. And he was on the on the radio out there, and they needed a song to open a movie up with, and they were looking for it, and it was Glenn Ford that picked out this song. His kid was playing it, and it was Rock Around the Clock. They threw it on there, and everyone forgets what the movie is. I mean, some people know, of course, but they picked out this song and said, here, let's use this. And one of these days, I'm going to get a hold of Bill's son and ask him if I can replay or we'll reshoot the interview. I was very fortunate about 2 years ago to have a long interview with the father of rock and roll, I will say, his son. And we talked about all kinds of stuff, you know. And I'll say, you know, like back in those times, Little Richard and a lot of those other people, they're all major players. Chubby Checker was later. But even Elvis was a year later after that. So, mm-hmm. I mean, Anyway, okay, so let's get some. Let's do a little bit of housekeeping. Coming up at 9 o'clock, we have a Rocket Valley special. It's Muriel Anderson, a harp guitarist. Definitely want to take a look at this. Beautiful music. Okay, the harp guitarist is a very unique instrument, and I mistakenly kind of compare it to another unique instrument in there. And the only reason is because I like unique instruments. I like the differences that this instrument can bring to, you know, the music industry. And when you see this harp guitar and you hear what this harp guitar can do, you'll be fascinated. And Muriel is just such a wonderful person. We decided to move it forward as a special, mainly because it is such a unique experience overall, but also she has a number of things coming up in the coming weeks, a birthday party, an album release, and a few other things. So please tune in and you know, stay with us here on Rock in the Valley. It will be releasing at 9 o'clock, so we're going to be cutting ourselves off probably about 2 minutes right before that. Tomorrow night we got Ralph. He'll be back with a new episode of Artist Spotlight. He'll be on at 8. Okay. Also, last night with Music 101, we had an awesome show with Demon Boy. Okay. Definitely want to catch that when you get a chance. There's music at first to take a look at it, and if you're an old country boy like myself, you know, your hat flies off and your boots melt. You know, you sit back and you think, you got to take a look at it. It's all, it's wild. I really enjoyed some of this stuff. I enjoyed all of it, actually, to tell you. And I've gotten a chance to meet Demon Boy, talk with him, and we've discussed having him come on the show and have a one-on-one meet and greet. So we're going to talk about that, and we'll be getting that out there to people and whoever wants to do that. But it will be a meet and greet here on Zoom. When I say meet and greet, I'm not saying in chat. I'm going to bring you on Zoom, and you're going to meet the one and the only amazing Demon Boy, okay? Also, coming ahead in future weeks, we've got Ronnie Lee, guitarist, who played with a number of different people out there. Let me just bring this up again so I can find it. She'll be coming forward probably about 2 weeks or a week. She was on with Venus and the Razor Blades. She's a punk rock band. That was created by the legendary Kim Fowley. She's featured on such shows as Defiance, Midnight in Texas, and The American Housewife, and others. You can find her at ronnieleegroup.com. But we'll be bringing her on with Music 101. She'll be coming up soon. And also, we've got the 2015 Hall of Famer. That's how we got going on with Joan Jett. Ricky Bird, the guitarist. So we've got that coming next week. We've got Common Bond and the Third Hand Acoustic. We'll be here on with our new co-host, Sherry Bain. She'll be on Tuesday night. We also have Not for Coltrane kicking off Monday night next week with the Not for Coltrane Tom Cooney Hour at 7 o'clock. So I know I threw a whole bunch of stuff at you. Just watch what's going on up in Rocket Valley. We try to keep you abreast of everything that's going on. I could use somebody to help out with keeping schedules. That'd be nice. And when I say keeping it, I mean putting it up online, because I got all kinds of things going on. I'll bring you on board. Then I'm going to go take a vacation. So anyway, okay, that's what we got going on. Anything else? No. Okay. So, Mr. McKnight.
Yes.
Tell, you're 18 years old. You reached out to me. You said, I want to play on your show. You sent me some stuff. By the time I got around to it on Instagram, it expired. Okay? So we play hit and miss for a while. And I've heard your stuff. And, you know, and this is pretty cool. You're a young man who's getting his first taste of music. So
yes.
My first question is this, okay? What's your feeling? What are you seeing in the Lehigh Valley music industry? Why? Because you told me your mindset's somewhere else. Okay, you know you're not, music is not your primary run. But what's your gig? Where are you coming from here? Tell us about it.
Well, I just I love music. I want to share it with everyone. I love playing for people. And yeah, that's pretty much it. It's super simple.
Okay. Have you had a chance to play out yet in the Valley? Are you still pretty much doing stuff privately, you know, in homes and that kind of stuff?
I got to play a little bit. I played live at like a park, like a chicken dinner. Played live at some friends' houses. I've been recently going to open mics, so.
That's good. That's a good start.
Yeah. Well, so I'm like just starting.
Hopefully you'll come out to the barn, you know, out to the farm, you know, on some Sunday if you're available. But you're doing something else. You're following through. Okay. You're going to be playing your guitar, but you're going to be doing something else. And you're going to be out of here soon. So tell us a little bit about that.
So September 7th, I'm shipping off to Basic to join the Coast Guard.
Okay, so this is kind of cool. Here it is, Memorial Day weekend, and we're bringing on a future vet right here. So I can thank you in advance for stepping up to serve. That's a big step. What made you choose the Coast Guard over the Navy or the Marines or?
Well, for one, I love the ocean. My family actually, we lived on a sailboat for 2 years before we recently just got back to the Valley. And that really just inspired me, like seeing that cutter cutting across the water, hearing them on the radio and stuff. And I don't know, I've looked into it a lot, and compared to the other branches, that one really suited me best.
I see. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. The branch we're concerned about here is what you got there with the guitar, and you got a little surprise for us to believe on with a harp. So let's let's kick it off here with something. Go ahead, kick it off with something.
All right, I'll start off with a song I wrote, actually.
Now, I did just get a request that came over here. Somebody wants you to sing in Swahili. Can you do that?
I cannot do that. I'm so sorry.
All right. Well, we'll just have to translate later. Never mind.
I actually know a song in French, if that works. I mean, I don't know what it exactly says in the song. I kind of got a gist of it.
Be careful. All right.
It's a song by Jack Johnson.
I will tell you this before you get started. I took French in high school, and I took it because they said it was the romance language. I thought, ooh, I'll wow the girl. So I walked up to a girl once, and I said something in French because she was French-Canadian, and I got slapped. Mm-hmm. Just letting you know. It's not always works out the way you want it to. Okay, go ahead and play your piece.
Yeah, all right. I'm hoping the guitarist that wrote the song I learned kind of was saying something along the lines of, like, you know, romance. So I don't have to, like, make up my own words in French and then probably mess it up. But anyways, here's my original.
All right, here we go.
All right. The day I saw you melted my heart like mosaic art. Out the front door into my arms, you are my world, just what you are. She walks and talks, but I'm in a stare. The beauty she holds, she's not aware. I have it all in your gorgeous smiles, just your voice. I'd go the miles. A gap in time, our love it grows. Call you mine, won't let you go. Gap in time, our love it grows. Call you mine, won't let you go. Won't let you go. Won't let you go. Won't let you go. Today I saw you falling for you. I lost my shoe. You are my world, that's just what you are. And I can't believe we're looking at stars. Cause you're the one, it's you all alone. My love for you is more than this song. Cause you're the one, it's you all along. And I can't believe I waited this long. A gap in time, our love it grows. Call you mine, won't let you go. Gap in time, our love it grows. Call you mine, won't let you go. Won't let you go. Won't let you go. Won't let you go. I can't hear you right now. I don't know.
That's because your producer's a klutz, all right? I forgot to turn my mic on.
I hope I wasn't muted.
No, you were good. You were great. I listened to everything there, and I'm listening to the stuff going out, and people are really liking what they're hearing.
That's good.
I'm not sure. Wait a minute. What the heck? How come I'm not hearing this over? One, two. I know why it's not. There it is. Okay. Wait, I want to make sure I'm hearing every. Okay, yeah. Okay, everyone. I got Ben Walker out here. Okay.
Yeah, I know Ben.
You know
yeah.
Ben? Okay.
Yeah.
Ben's watching. Thanks, Ben, for tuning in. I got Justine McKnight.
Yep.
You're
That's
married?
My aunt.
Oh, your aunt. Oh, okay. I was going to say, wow, you got married already. Okay. There's an Abigail.
Mm-hmm.
Celeste. Yeah. Let's say hi to her. Okay. So you got some people watching you.
Hey, guys.
Yeah. They're liking what you're doing. That's good. Yeah. I'm liking what you're doing. You sound good. So how long have you been playing guitar?
Trying to think. Maybe like 2 years, 3 years.
That long? And your hands aren't tired?
No.
That's a long time to play. I mean, you guys set the guitar down to eat, you know.
Oh. Sorry, I read the question wrong.
No, so you've been playing about 3 years. I'll tell you what, for 3 years, you're not too bad. Now, you said that you worked on a little bit on piano, and you also got the harp going on there, and that's three instruments.
Yeah.
And is that all done in the last 3 years?
Yes, it is, yeah. The harmonica's more recent. Piano's more recent. Guitar is really like the 3 year one. I would say harp and piano. Piano's probably been 2 years, harp has been like one.
Now, this is an honest question here. What would make you pick up an instrument and start playing instruments, you know, at 15 years old? Why didn't you do it when you're eight? You know.
Well, that's a funny story, actually. When we moved on a sailboat.
Oh, okay. No room to put a piano. I can get that. It would sink.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. We didn't have Wi-Fi. Some things at first we were limited to, just like the everyday hobbies and school and stuff. We were homeschooled, and my dad brought a guitar on the sailboat that we were living on, to learn it, and. Me and my brothers, nothing musical. But then one day, me and my brother Petey decided to pick up the guitar. He actually started playing first on this just junk guitar. It has like a It's like a guitar center guitar. It has like a huge crack in it and stuff. Strings are all rusty from the salt water.
there goes that sponsor. All right.
He basically picked up guitar and I was like, oh, that's dope. Like, cause he sounded good. And then I was like, I'm going to play some bass. I'll back you up. So I actually bought an acoustic bass. We got that shipped to like a marina we were at. And then we started playing together. And then that was really our first touch into like music and stuff. And, you know, playing with people. So fun.
That is really cool. So when you lived on this. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah. And then eventually I got kind of sick of the bass. And then I moved to guitar. And then eventually from guitar, I started looking to songs I loved. I like Jack Johnson. I learned a lot of his songs. That's acoustic guitar, singing and playing. And then from there.
Wow. So I'm going to, just to digress briefly. So you lived on, I'm getting this vision that you're sailing around the world or you're out in the middle of an ocean or something like that on this sailboat. and it's obviously it's not your characteristic sailboat people think of that you would see on like Lake Wall and Paul Pack where, you know, there's a very tiny cabin. We're talking something serious here, right? What is it, like a 60-foot schooner or something like that or? I don't know.
40-foot catamaran.
A catamaran.
Yeah.
Okay.
40-foot catamaran. Look that up. I had my own bedroom on it.
Really?
It's pretty awesome.
Wow.
Yeah.
So
I had my own bathroom. Yeah.
In the words, you had your own bathroom.
Yeah. Well, me and my brother shared it, but yeah, for the most part.
Okay. So one of my movies I really enjoy, but I didn't like it when I was your age, but I liked it now. Was Jaws, and they always said about getting a bigger boat. But you're okay though, right?
I don't know. I don't know if our boat could take on that size of a shark. But
I'm gonna tell you what. It doesn't matter the size of the shark. Okay, or like if I was with you on the boat and we saw that, I guarantee you that boat's fast enough to get away from the shark. Because
that's the thing, though.
I'll get in
that.
I
wasn't that.
I'll be in the water and I'll push the boat and I'll start kicking. Man, I'm going to tell you what, that boat's going to pop a wheelie. So, all right. So, what's your next song quickly before Steve starts going? We need a bigger boat.
All right. I'm gonna play some Heart of Gold by Neil Young.
By Neil Young, Heart of Gold. Okay. This yes. would be cool. Good song.
Make sure I got the right key. All right. We're good. One second.
Uh-oh. You have to put your braces on here. Okay.
Yeah. All right, here we go. I wanna live, I wanna give. I've been a miner for a heart of gold. It's these expressions I never give that keeps me searching for a heart of gold. And I'm getting old. keeps me searching for a heart of gold, and I'm getting old. I've been to Hollywood, I've been to Redwood, I crossed the ocean for a heart of gold. I've been in my mind, it's such a fine line, it keeps me searching for a heart of gold, and I'm getting old. Keeps me searching for a heart of gold, and I'm getting old. Keep me searching for a heart of gold. You keep me searching and I'm growing old. You keep me searching for a heart of gold. I've been a miner for a heart of gold. Uh-huh.
Okay. Excuse me. I should have cleared my throat beforehand. Heart of Gold, Neil Young. That's good.
Yes.
It sounded great. And your
thanks.
Your harmonica. We did this beforehand, and had we practiced it, it would have been fun. We could have done the piano, man, because we were kind of messing around just on the keys.
Yeah.
But you seem diverse. Oh, wait a minute. Why does my mic sound so hot? Hang on a second. Kind of weird. There we go. That better? Yeah. I'm amazed by the fact that you've picked up these instruments at 15 and just kind of taken off with them. And I mean, really, I mean, I've worked with kids as young as 14 years old, but a lot of them have gone through like the Bethlehem School of Arts. They've gone through School of Rock, or they've gone through the Lesson Center. And I've had some self-taught kids come in as well. And I see a wide berth of kids. And, you know, you're very unique in what you do. You are. You're showing a very strong talent, which is fantastic. You know.
Thank you.
So what I'm thinking is, if you ever run out of ammo, you could sing them to sleep. I mean, you know, just sit there and just play, and everyone's going to be happy. And, you know, like the bad guys are going to just say, hey, man, this guy's cool. We're just going to sit and listen to the music. So that would be nice if it worked out that way, wouldn't it? So then you miss a chord and they sink your boat. But anyway, So you're a Neil Young fan. That's very unusual for somebody who's 18 years old, and that's 40 years ago.
A lot of my music comes from 40 years ago that I'm, like, playing, that I'm covering.
That's like me playing Tchaikovsky. I mean, you know, but then, of course, you know, somebody would come along and say, Steve, was top 10 when you were a kid. Right now, the music scene is very much into what you're playing. You know, the single guitar going out with a tip jar, and you get $50 or $100, you know, from the place, then you sit around and start playing. So, you know, this is the music, you know, some Joe Walsh perhaps, or Fleetwood Mac, or what have you. know, that's that's the stuff. That, you know, if you know some Johnny Cash, but you gotta be careful because that is getting kind of old. People start knocking the dust off that stuff, and it's I play it. It's like, huh, what is that? You know, but you know who Chubby Checker is?
I do not.
I am in pain. It is. Do you know who Elvis Presley is?
Yes. Yeah.
Whew, do you know how close you came to losing the entire show? But wait a minute. I mean, it was like, thank you very much. I'm glad that you knew that.
Okay, oh, so. Got the shades.
I got the wig too. It's not within reach. All right. So, what do you got for us next?
Here, let me look. I wrote it down. Oh, Mary Jane's Last Dance by Tom Petty.
God, what? I did a Tom Petty thing, and that's all he played. All right, go ahead. That's all right. No, I'm just kidding. I'm busting your chops. I had a kid on one time. I had them so screwed up. My live rock youth shows were so much fun. You know, before you get into Mary Jane, you write your own. You have a couple of your own. What gives an 18-year-old an inspiration? What makes you think I'm gonna write a song? I mean, are you gonna write about Pac-Man? Or what's Pac-Man? Okay.
No, I know what Pac-Man is.
Oh,
please.
Goody. So, you know, what gives you the inspiration to write about a song? I got a little story behind that. But go ahead. But what inspires you?
I don't know. Living on the ocean was a huge part of it. And
that is so cool.
A girl.
Yeah, I get that.
A girl's always inspiring, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It can. It works.
Yep, that, it does. A lot of artists do that, I think, only.
That's why you're right. Well, Mary Jane's not about a girl. But anyway, no.
What are you? It's about a girl.
Okay.
It's a joke.
I'll just let it for go. That. There was a kid on the show a few years ago. We were over at the farm, and I asked her the same question. And I'm going to do my best impersonation of this kid. She's great. I'm looking forward to her coming on again. Okay. But she's this cowboy girl. And I said, what inspires you? And she's 14, 13 years old, 12, something like that. And she goes, well, there's so much drama in our school. She goes, it's just the drama. And I jumped out. And this video is on our archive. I jumped out from the side stage. I said, you're kidding, like that. I just scared the living life out of this kid. If her shoes wouldn't have been tied, she would have jumped right out of them. So it was just funny. All right, Mary Jane, go for it.
Mary Jane, all right. She grew up in an Indiana town, had a good-looking mama who never was around. But she grew up tall and she grew up right with them Indiana boys on an Indiana knife. Well, she moved down here, the age of 18. She blew the boys away, it was more than they'd seen. I was introduced, we both started grooving. Said I dig you, baby, but I gotta keep moving on. Keep moving on. Last dance with Mary Jane, one more time to kill the pain. I feel summer creeping in and I'm tired of this town again. I don't know, but I've been told you never slow down, you never grow old. Tired of screwing up, I'm tired of going down, I'm tired of myself, I'm tired of this town. Oh my my, oh hell yes, honey, put on that party dress, buy me a drink, play me a song, and take me as I come, cause I can't stay long. Last dance with Mary Jane, one more time to kill the pain. I feel summer creeping in, and I'm tired of this town again. Pigeons down on the market square, she's standing in her underwear, looking down from a hotel room, the nightfall will be coming soon. Oh my my, oh hell yes, you got to put on that party dress, it was too cold to cry when I woke up alone, hit my last number, walked to the road, last dance with Mary Jane, one more time to kill the pain. I feel summer creeping in, and I'm tired of this town again.
Hey, okay, that was good.
Thanks.
I was.
I had a one problem during that song. My chord here, every time I went to go up, because the guitar in the song like does this thing with the A's, goes to like higher octaves.
Okay.
I was scared I was gonna rip down my whole interface, because when I got up to this A, all the way up here, this cord was like stuck on my arm every time.
I didn't notice it. It was. I thought you were gonna say your horn section wouldn't respond right, but anyway.
That was just annoying me.
I tell you what, my thing. Okay, this is my third or fourth set of headphones. I get going and I set things going back and forth here, and I forget I'm wearing headphones. And I jump up and I go to do something else, and it's still plugged in. I drag a mixer with me.
Oh, it just. That's not good.
No, it's not.
That'll get you a new mixer real quick.
No, the mixer survives. It's usually the headset goes. Yeah. It's, you know, or if it, depending on what it's wrapped around, a couple other things come along with it, tripod, a couple of cameras. You know, it's like it's kind of. The good part is I get to reorganize my desk usually. So yeah, cords are a pain, and you know, maybe they'll come out with wireless mics one day and headsets. Have you checked out the price on wireless stuff lately?
What is it? No, I haven't.
Oh my god, I mean, a single wireless mic is in the 200 range, 300 range.
What?
Yeah, and then I was gonna buy a new set of headset, you know, with a mic on it and that thing.
Yeah,
and something decent that's gonna, you know, respond well in here, and it's got the right curve, you know, right, the right response curve and everything else. I'm looking at $350 to $400. And it's like, ow! Pull out the knife,
that
man!
Hurts.
Come on, that's like, come on, we're out of control here. So I just put up with this, but that's all right. I mean, it's $15, and then when I ruin it. And, you know, I'll get as much life out of it as I can. So, you know, but when you ruin it, you got to spend another $15. I mean, there's a lot of $15 in $350. I really don't need that. That's, you know. But maybe one day. One day when I grow up to be big and strong, I want to get myself something like that, I'll do it. I'll buy it for my birthday. But I prefer spending it. You know what I prefer spending on, honestly? Right here. I got a pretty new camera.
Wait, I can't.
Can you see it?
Oh, yeah, yep. Is that a camera?
Yeah, I got two of these things. We take these out to the field. Like, if you're playing somewhere, like if you stop at a camel hump, okay?
The farm, I will. No pun intended.
Right. I'm looking forward to this, okay? Again, but I got to get more batteries, all right? Because I'm burning through batteries like mad out there, and I have to use two cameras to cover the entire event. Start one, shut one down, start up. Anyway, I know how to do the editing where I can run the sound between the two and do all kinds of stuff. I got two of these things. And it's fun. I mean, it's a hobby. It keeps me out of trouble most of the time. And anyway, shut up, Steve. All right, so here we go. I'm going to go over a list of people here. You have got one heck of a fan base, kid.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah. Nicole. Nicole Beth. She's
Beth.
Yeah, she's doing a woohoo.
I know who that is.
Yeah, Vicky McKnight.
And Nikki.
Vicky, yeah, Vicky is giving you a big woohoo. Lindsay Garrett McKnight, she's doing a, like, woo. Okay, I'm getting a so awesome from Nicole. Eileen Abruzzi, I'll bet I even said that right. Justine, she's hanging in there. She loves it. Okay. She even likes my dad jokes. Okay, there is therapy, Justine. Carolyn, all the way from Canada. So yeah, you're international. Okay. And I was talking about Abigail and Celeste. Okay, that's who's over on Facebook. And over on the people who are responding in text, sure, I can't read it. Andre, there's no way I'm going to say his last name. Andrly.
Nope, that's my friend Andre. Andre.
How do you say his last name?
Seminovich.
I should have known that, being Hungarian. You know, because my mother's last name has got like 5 million letters, and you know, you say one word. So, but anyway. So, okay, let's keep on moving. They want to hear more of your music and less of me. So what else you got?
Here, let me look. I have like a thing. How many more songs do I got?
If I keep my mouth shut, we can probably squeeze in at least three more. It's at 45 right now. So I'll tell you what. Let's do this because I want them to hear more of you. Let's do two in succession. Just go from one to the next, okay?
Okay.
All right, yeah, let's do that.
I can do that. Okay, cool. All right. This next song is by the Beatles. It's called Hide Your Love Away. Just make sure so.
Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall. If she's gone, I can go on, feeling 2 foot small. Everywhere people stare, each and every day. I can see them laugh at me, and I hear them say, hey, you've got to hide your love away. Hey, you've got to hide your love away. How can I even try? I can never win. Hearing them, seeing them in the state I'm in. Lundia said to me, love will find a way. Gather round all you clowns, let me hear you say, hey, you've got to hide your love away. Hey, you've got to hide your love away.
Thank you. Muted.
Oh, keep going. No, yeah, keep right. going. Keep all going.
Right. All right.
I got an idea for the end of the show, but yeah, keep on going. And don't go real long in this one because we're going to and make sure you got your harmonica on for the end of the show, okay?
But it's going to have to change key. Because I think I know what you want to do, but I'm going to have to change key of the harmonica at the very end.
Okay, whatever you got to do, just move right along.
All right. It's just kind of like the closer. I got a finger-style song left. Do you want to hear Rolling Stones or Bob Dylan?
Oh, I don't care. You're great. Right. You're great either way. I wish we had more time. but we're going to run out, and I've got Muriel coming on at 9. And so I definitely want to be off for her, but what we're going to do, we can bring you back at some point in time. Okay. And
yeah, for sure.
You're going to be on when we're at the farm, and we're going to do something really kind of cool here at the end of the show. I got to watch my time. So, if you want, we can just do your thing and just do a short version of us. We got time to do this.
Yep. All right. All right.
Big treat coming up, guys. All right. Stay with us.
It ain't no use in sitting wonder why, babe, if ain't you know by now. And it ain't no use in sitting wonder why, babe, it'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on. Don't think twice, all right. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe. That light I never know. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe. I'm on the dark side of the road. But I wish there was something you would do or say to try to make me change my mind and stay. We never did too much talking anyway. Don't think twice, all right. No, it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, like you never did before. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, I can't hear you anymore. I'm a thinking and a wondering, walking on down the road. I once loved a woman, a child I'm told. Gave her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's alright. So long, honey, babe. Where I'm bound, I can't tell. But goodbye's too good of a word, babe. So I'll just say fare thee well. I ain't saying you treated me unkind. Could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kinda wasting my precious time. Don't think twice, all right.
All right. Now,
What key are you playing that in? I'm not saying. Oh, excellent. Okay, I'll have to make any changes.
Oh yeah, that's spot on. I haven't played this one in a minute though, so if I mess up.
No, I'm gonna follow you.
Sorry.
Okay.
All right. This might be tough over Zoom too.
Now this actually works with its only two people. With you sending to me, because I will synchronize to you, then it gets sent out.
Okay.
That should work. I'm gonna be watching. Hang on a second. There's like damn mice here. I gotta tell you, like all these critters on my freaking thing. All right. Okay. A note to everyone out there: if it sounds like we're out of sync, say so in the notes, if you please. I'm monitoring the notes over on Facebook, and I am monitoring. Hang on. God, why do I got so many of these? And I'm monitoring over on on YouTube. All right. How's the volume there? How's the volume?
You talking to me? Because I think it sounds good.
No, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the guy sitting off to your right.
Sorry, I didn't know if you were like talking to the chat, you know?
I'm going to tell you, I really love working with kids. I do, because every now and again they do something. I've got a 28-year-old daughter, okay? I have four kids, okay? And the reason I have four is because I didn't want five. And sometimes this stuff that happens is just I'm on the phone with my daughter and she never mind. All right, let's do this. Go ahead.
Okay, all right. Do you want to do like a little instrumental or do you want to do like
let's just do a short instrumental because we try to synchronize the singing on that. We're gonna end up doing a Talladega hitting the wall here.
All right, ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Okay.
Go for it. Ain't working. All right.
With the guitar, it's tough. It's tough over Zoom. I gotta come in the studio for that one.
Yeah, we're gonna have to do it that way because we were close. And you know what the problem was? I couldn't hear. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We wanted to give it a shot and surprise you, and we blew it. Okay, but.
Dang Zoom.
It
wasn't us.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't our fault. It's not my fault.
The talent was there.
The talent was definitely there. So I got to have you come over here, and we'll sit here and we'll do it here. Okay.
Heck yeah.
And
for sure.
And just to mention that, Mr. the Piano Man himself is playing down the shore. Tommy Zito, very good friend of mine. Okay. And if you want to see him, he's down in Wildwood. And we're down to the breaking point here. It's we're 4 minutes of 9 o'clock. Mary Ellen Anderson's coming up straight ahead. And with the harp guitar, which is a fabulous thing, which is why we're kind of compressing ourselves here. I want you back, young man. I want to get here, have you in the studio. We're going to jam a little bit.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
I'm so down.
Oh, yeah. And we'll just we'll work on some pieces here. And I got to tell you what, I heard you're doing with the it's all Don't Think Twice, It's All Right. I mean, you can probably get into some Cash. I've got a gal who sings with me who does Johnny Cash. Okay, and we've done Jackson and Guitar Picking Man, some other stuff. I do Ring of Fire, like it's.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And you come in as a guitar. Oh yeah, I've been. I forgot the words all of a sudden, but yeah, Ring of Fire, Ring of Fire. I made one of them one time with my car. Just keep spinning around.
Oh yeah.
So. Where can we find you? Are you publishing yet, or do you have anything out? Where can we find you?
Nah, you can just look at my Instagram, my Facebook. Instagram's just Will McKnight Music, and my Facebook is just William McKnight.
Okay.
I can send you the links to those if you want to put in the description of this video.
Yeah. Well, no, put them in the comment section under, because this is going to – should have had them beforehand. Just put – when you go back into it on YouTube and over on Rock in the Valley on Facebook – just go back in and in the comments section, put your links in there, and that'll be fine. Yeah, you should be problem with it. Kevin.
Sounds good.
We had Kevin to come in here. Kevin Braun. Kevin, thanks for joining us. And I will tell you, this was a blast. I did. You're a great young artist. I'm looking forward to having you get around to some of the more of the open mics. You've got a great sound. And you've got only 2 months to make your footprint here, and then off we go into the wild. No, wait, that's wrong. Anchors Away, kind of. They have a different song for it. I just had played it yesterday. I can't think of it. So I've got to sign off. You were a great guest, young man, and I'm really glad
reached
out.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, and you got a lot of great comments from it and everything else. So, yeah, man, it's cool.
That's good.
It's cool.
Yeah.
So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to say thank you all for joining us tonight. And it's been a blast, and I'm glad to see people from Canada joining us. That's really great. It's did you get snow the last weekend? It was over the weekend, because we got enough rain down here to build an ark. I mean, it was bad. But at any rate, coming straight ahead, stay tuned on Rock in the Valley. Watch for the next live feed to come up behind us. It won't be with this broadcast, but it'll we have another broadcast that's going to start right up. It's with Muriel Anderson. It's a Rock in the Valley special. It was pre-recorded. It's a harp guitar, and it is some of the most beautiful music you will ever hear. It's about 30 minutes long, and maybe 45, something like that. And she's from around the world, and it's worth it to hang in there and just watch it. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming. Good night. God bless, and stay safe. We'll see you next week. Don't forget, tomorrow night, Ralph, is at 8 o'clock. Good night, all.